Pluto was the ninth planet, although eventually it's reclassified. But at least, Pluto is the largest dwarf planet in the solar system. Or is it? Absolutely it is. But has Pluto always been the largest dwarf planet? Which brings us to our topic of the day, a really exciting new study that basically confirms that Triton, the biggest moon of planet Neptune, seems to be a former dwarf planet. Specifically, there are a lot of signs that not only do these objects appear to be kind of similar, they were also very likely formed in the same way. So, let's dive into it. While you may not know much about this object, here's how Triton compares to our cute moon and Pluto. It is not only the largest moon of Neptune, it even has an atmosphere around itself. But unfortunately, there's only been one mission that took pictures of Triton in the process, the Voyager 2. But it was good enough. And since then, many interesting things going around on Triton have been uncovered. For example, we're pretty certain it has a relatively complex atmosphere composed mostly of nitrogen but also some methane and carbon monoxide. It also generates clouds. So, technically, along with Titan, the moon of Saturn, Triton is the only other moon that's known to have a relatively complex atmosphere. But unlike Titan, the atmospheric pressure here is really low, it's about 0.002% of Earth's. But you know what, it's extremely similar to what we actually observe on Pluto, with both possessing very similar composition and even very similar effects when it comes to seasonal changes. Also, it's a 15% larger than Pluto in radius and 65% more massive. So, if this was a dwarf planet, it would be the largest. But again, in terms of composition, it's once again extremely similar to Pluto, 1/3 of ice and 2/3 of rocks. But there are of course a few things that are unusual, for example, it orbits the Neptune in the opposite direction. A retrograde orbit, which already means it's extremely unlikely to have formed around Neptune naturally because normal moons form with the planet, and everything moves in one direction.
So,
it was probably captured from somewhere else and assumed its orbit billions of years ago. But the question is,
what exactly happened here?
Well, as you can probably imagine, this was some kind of an interplanetary capture, and the most likely theory tells a story like this.
Shortly after the solar system formed, there was a period when gas giants lost their gravitational balance and moved around like crazy. Neptune was thrown into the early Kuiper belt and had some wonderful days with the stuffs there, and one of them was Triton, that approached Neptune close enough. But Triton at that time was a binary object. By the way, these binary objects are actually very common in the Kuiper belt. And so as this binary system approached Neptune, the gravitational interaction broke apart this binary, with one of the objects being expelled somewhere else but the other object staying behind, basically becoming this unusual moon.
So, the case for Triton coming from somewhere else, and specifically from the Kuiper belt, seems to be pretty strong, but it wasn't until recently that humans started to link this object to Pluto. For example, unlike other moons and a lot of other Kuiper belt objects, both Pluto and Triton are pretty reflective. Triton reflects about 75% of sunlight, which makes it one of the coldest objects in the solar system. The temperature is about 38 Kelvin or -235 degrees Celsius, about the same as Pluto. On top of this, both objects seem to show signs of a lot of geological activity happened recently. For example, on both, we seem to observe a lot of dark material, usually organic compounds, that must have been ejected from within and must have come from some kind of an underground ice ocean. But in this recent study where the scientists conducted a very thorough elemental analysis of Triton and Pluto, they basically concluded that these objects have to be siblings and were most likely formed in an extremely similar environment. And here, they essentially conducted a ratio analysis based on various elements that, in essence, shows us the overall composition of Triton and Pluto compared to everything else, and these two objects really stand out here. The ratio of a lot of different elements seems to be practically identical but quite different from other objects in the solar system, like both in an extremely nitrogen-rich environment, both a lot of methane and carbon monoxide, which kind of implies that both objects must have formed in a very similar region and might have been even closely related prior to some kind of a separation. Yet somehow, Pluto stayed behind and still orbits in a similar location today, but for some reason, Triton didn't. So if Triton was in a binary system, what was the other object? Pluto already has Charon, so it can't be Pluto. However, we've found some others similar to these two. Eris, which seems to be similar in size, composition, density, reflectivity, and a lot of other properties but orbits much farther away from everything else, just like being thrown out by a big planet. Well, we really don't know much about these distant objects, but unfortunately, mankind simply isn't willing to pay to send probes around that far away. Alright, enjoy your 5 minutes spending with Triton, Pluto, and Eris. I will see you next Neptune.